Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, one and all. Welcome to our session of Zen of Python of DevNet Create 2021. Utkarsh and I will walk you through the session. But before that, I'll quickly introduce us. Utkarsh is working as a senior consulting engineer in professional services and responsible for leading multiple data science initiatives. Whereas I am Sayali, working as a network consulting engineer in Cisco for past 2.5 years, I am passionate about learning and implementing technologies, and hence I have been part of multiple initiatives within Cisco. And before diving straight into this session, I would like to ask you one simple question. What is the most frustrating thing that could happen to a developer? Well, one of the frustrating things that could happen to a developer is reading and understanding someone else's code, especially if that code is not written properly or with poor readability and modularity. But imagine if we could tackle this problem by following few best practices in Python. Yes, in this session, we will be talking about 20 such best practices that states how one can write clean and beautiful code with Python. It came to be known as the Zen of Python. It's a poem written by Tim Peters. It is a mini style guide for all the Python users. But it is also interesting if you don't program in Python. Now, as a developer, you need not go and do a Google search every time. Instead, what you can do, you just go to your Python interpreter and typing import this, and here you are. You will get the complete poem in front of you. Now, without wasting any more time, let's enjoy and decode this beautiful poem one by one. First one, it says, beautiful is better than ugly. Well, who doesn't like the beautiful code? Being a developer, writing the code and making it run is not the only job we do, right? Python is known for its readability and simplicity. So why to tamper it? Writing clean and beautiful readable code is an important art, which is appreciated by many other programmers. Now here, as you can see, the first code is written with so many lines, but it can be written with a small set of snippets, right? So that's why beautiful is better than ugly. Explicit is better than implicit. Your code should never create a confusion in the mind of a person who is trying to read it. For example, every time you are calling a function, you should name the module explicitly. Hiding the code functionality might have consequences, as other programmers might not be able to understand the code at all. So all we can do is to be specific and concrete about whatever we are writing into the code. Simple is better than complex. Obviously, why to build a complex code when you can build a very simpler one? As you can see on the screen, the first code that we have written is with a little bit complex lines and some more features, etc., but it can be written with simple two lines of code. Complex is better than complicated. It says that complex is something which is doing a thing which is hard to understand, whereas complicated is overdoing things again and again. A complex problem might require a complex technique to overcome it, but it shouldn't be complicated. For example, in the first line of code, as we can see, if you want to print first 5 whole numbers, for that, you are defining a new variable counter and putting a while loop where counter is less than 5. We are just keep on iterating and increasing the value. But it can be done with the help of simple for loop and a range function. So we are avoiding overdoing of things and ending up into the complicated solution. So we need to prefer a simplicity, but it's crucial to know the limits of simplicity. Next one is flat is better than nested, where programmers love to organize things into categories, especially categories that contain subcategories, which contain other subcategories. So it's like we are making the code way too complicated. Now, example, I am making a module name called spam, adding a submodule called foo and another as baz. If I want to access some sub package from the bus, it's making it way more complicated and nested. So always flat is better than nested. Next one says sparse is better than dense. Sometimes we tend to do everything in just one line of code. But look at this line. Where is the readability? So it's always good to break the code down into small parts and use it as a proper readable code. So sparse is better than dense. Readability counts. So imagine if you are referring two codes from some website, what code do you look at? Readable one or a complicated one? Obviously, readable one. Next one says special cases aren't special enough to break the rules. Programmer must follow all the good programming practices, although practicality beats the purity. So special cases aren't enough to break the rules, and if you really want to get the desired behavior, you are supposed to use a one practical approach. For example, if I ask you 1.1 minus 0.9, what is your answer? Obviously, it is 0.2. But in Python, we will be getting the answer in decimal points. Now, if you want to make it a true, for example, here I'm writing 1.1 minus 0.2 is equals to 0.2, which is stating it as a false statement. To make it right, I'm going to use a round function. So walking the lines between these two aphorisms becomes easier with experience. And in time, you will not only learn the rules, but you will also learn when to break them. Next one, it says it is better to get errors, but not the silent errors. Errors should never pass silently unless explicitly silenced. Because whenever we are getting silent errors, these errors will later on lead to bugs or some further crashes. Hence, best practice is to handle them. In the face of ambiguity, refuse the temptation to guess. All the computers do what we want them to do. But if your code isn't working properly, we need to sit down. We need to use a careful and critical thinking to solve it. What most of the programmers do is to refuse. They just try on guessing some of the solutions until something seems to work. Often you have masked the problem rather than solve it after doing this. So in the face of ambiguity, just make sure you are refusing the temptation to guess it. Next one is says there should be one and preferably only one obvious way to do it. Using three, four codes to do the same thing is just like having double-edged sword. So not only it consumes time to write, but every fellow must be able to read your three, four methods without any issues, right? So it's better to use only one preferable solution. The next one is just a joke referring to BDFL, where it says that the language rule will not be easy to learn or recall unless and until you are the creator of the code. Executing now and making incorrect results is not good. Instead of that, let's wait a bit and get output with correct results. That's why it says now is better than never, although never is often better than right now. There is a famous saying from Albert Einstein, and if the implementation is hard to explain, obviously it's a bad idea. If the implementation is easy to explain, it's a good idea. So make sure we are writing a code simpler for programmers as well, instead of making it simpler only for the computers. Last but not the least is the namespaces. So namespaces have given a good importance in this poem. It helps to use certain names again and again in different scopes. Namespaces are one honking idea. Let's use namespaces and avoid name conflicts within the code. So finally, this brings us to the last line of the poem, which is line number 20, which has been kept left blank by the time fitters. And it's up to you what you want to imply from it. Okay, so now it was a long poem and hope you like coding it with me. As we saw, many of them are contradictory. The ones we have discussed here can be argued against or may simply be relevant to your situation. But again, you will often hear Python developers asking many others that how Pythonic a piece of code is. By learning this principle of Zen of Python, you will be better at expressing your command in the way that works with Python. Happy coding!